let's welcome in retired Brigadier General and Iraq War veteran, also Congressman Scott Perry, Republican from Pennsylvania. Congressman, welcome to National Report. Good morning to you.
Good morning. And just listening to your reporting, it's very clear when it comes to protecting the American people, President Biden just simply never fails to fail. He failed to listen. He failed to learn. And now he's failing to lead. I guess he's on vacation at Camp David. He showed up to give us a bit of a briefing and then left without taking questions. I don't know how he's sleeping at night, because many of us are not, knowing that thousands of Americans are stranded somewhere behind enemy lines. And, you know, they're talking about efficiency at the airport. My goodness, when you're in a war zone, when you're in a combat zone, you don't tell people to shelter in place. That's for something if there's a storm going by outside and you need to, avoid the rain. That's not for circumstances where you can lose your life to an enemy combatant. It's completely out of touch, completely obtuse, and a complete abject failure of responsibility by the commander in chief.
And I know, Congressman, you come from military experience. At this point in the evacuation, where we don't know exactly how many Americans are still in Afghanistan, is it time for U.S. military personnel to head beyond the Kabul airport to actually start those rescue operations?
Well, I will tell you, it has to be the highest priority of this administration to get our American citizens out. Now, how that is done is probably going to be left up to military planners. But the fact that we're days into this right now, and we're just hearing within the last day and a half that they didn't have any plan to do that, is an abject failure. Heads need to roll. There needs to be accountability. This is unacceptable. It cannot be accepted. We need to get our people out now.
Again, we've been hearing from the State Department, it's just not matching up with some remarks we heard from General Mark Milley, who said the speedy demise of the Afghan government was unanticipated. Take a listen to the general.
The time frame of a rapid collapse, that was widely estimated and ranged from weeks to months and even years following our departure. There was nothing that I or anyone else saw that indicated a collapse of this army and this government in 11 days.
And yet we saw it fall. Why was there a lack of preparedness in this case?
This is an epic failure either of leadership at the DOD at the Mark Milley level or at the intel level. Somebody is responsible, one or the other. They both can't say that one's saying that we told them, the other's saying we didn't know anything about it. Somebody's lying and somebody's trying to cover their rear end here, and we need to get to bottom of it immediately. Our immediate focus needs to be about getting American citizens out and then accountability. This cannot be happening. We cannot continue to witness this, and Mark Milley and others are directly responsible.
You say, of course, focused on getting those American citizens out, but I also want to ask you about what's being left behind, and that's that U.S. military equipment now in the hands of the Taliban, most likely. Again, we were showing this video of the terrorist group's special forces carrying what's being reported as U.S.-made weapons as they make their way down the street. Looking back now, was there a way to avoid this scene that we're seeing play out?
Yes, of course there's a way to avoid it. It's why you haven't seen this scene in other places of similar circumstances. It just frosts me to no end to see this weaponry. I'm watching it on TV on your channel and other channels, watching American goods, taxpayer paid for munitions and military hardware being carried around by terrorists. We would never, under any competent leadership whatsoever, allow that to happen. Never, even if we just had to destroy it in place. There's always a plan for that. I served for many years from the ranks of enlisted to officer. You would never allow that to happen. That's 101. That's just rudimentary operation, standard operations. And it's unbelievable that there's this lack of leadership at this level in the United States of America. And of course, our enemies are all watching this. And quite honestly, our allies are very, and rightly so, very concerned about this turn of events and what it means for any alliance they have with the United States and their protection moving forward.
Yeah, I hear the passion in your voice. And of course, we thank you for your service and we thank you for joining us this morning. Congressman Scott Perry of Pennsylvania, thank you so much. Take care.
Hi, Emma Reckenberg here. If you like this video, there's a whole lot more to see on Newsmax TV. You can watch for free right here on our YouTube live stream and be the first one here each time our experts break down real news. Just hit that subscribe button, ring the bell icon, and stay with us on America's fastest growing cable news channel, Newsmax TV.